Yes, my new album came out on Monday, Gravel and Wine, and so far it's been nothing but great news of what I've heard. So yeah, I'm pretty excited. It's been like 2 days still though, so I'm still waiting on the blogs and the papers and the reviews, you know. But I'm not going to look too deeply into that, I don't think. I'm just going to walk around in rose-coloured glasses. yeah, I can't really pay attention to blogs and reviews too much because I think I'd go a little bit insane. You know, just if you're going to take good news, you've got to take bad news. So I'd rather just not take any of it, you know? Yeah. Yeah, I finished a tour about a couple of days ago, and I did five shows, all down the south and the north, and it was great. It was sold out tour, which was cool to come back to after a year off. And yeah, great to see my fans again, and my Kiwi fans, and just dip my toes in. I've learned since releasing Holy Smoke to now with Gravel and Wine, I've learned how to take things in my stride a little bit better and just kind of be relaxed and enjoy the moment of releasing a record and go, okay, cool, this is good, this is nice. If stuff goes bad, if stuff doesn't get done right, don't worry about it, don't sweat the small stuff, as long as the music's great. And just taught me that it's all about the songs. You've got to have great, great, great songs, and that's good. That's going to get you through whatever dramas happen along the way. Pistol for a mouth, my own mama gave me that, making my own road. Highlights this year for 2011 would be spending a lot of time in the States and going down to the southern parts of the States around Mississippi and Alabama and Memphis, and going to Graceland for the first time and learning about Elvis. Really getting to know America. Yeah, it's been a big highlight.
And Tom Powers. And to be honest, when I first heard about it, I thought that was quite brilliant. And good on Anika for just being honest. Because he was being a dick, you know what I mean? Like, I'm not going to get into it, but I think it's great that you can voice your opinion to each other. And if you have a biff about it, great. Sparks a bit of drama. Everyone loves drama. My favourite tattoo would be my bear. Actually, my bear. Because it was a last minute decision and I literally got picked up, went to the shops and bought a hunting magazine and found this bear inside the cup. I just went to the tattoo parlor and said, give me a bear. He was like, you're mental. I love it. It's good. What inspires me to write music would be people and situations and falling in love, and mainly falling out of love. Well, my favourite music magazine in New Zealand would have to be... Oh, it's a tough one. I can't think of anything. Rip It Up. Definitely Rip It Up, because they put me on the cover. I love it.